how many stereocenters do we have in this molecule? At the first glance, it would look like we have only one stereocenter, the chiral carbon. However, we need to consider about geometrical isomerism also here. Otherwise, we will be making a mistake here. So, the number of stereocenters here is 2. And the number of isomers or number of stereoisomers is equal to 2 to the power n. Here the n value is equal to 2. And therefore, the number of stereoisomers here is 4 isomers. Because if we are naming this molecule, how do you name it without considering stereoisomers? You can simply name it as pent-3-ene-2-ol. On the contrary, once you consider the stereoisomerism for the chiral carbon, then it will be R and S. But then you have to consider geometrical isomerism, cis and trans also here. Or you would like to, you can call it as E and Z. So 3E and 3Z also. This 3E will have R and S, and this 3Z also will have R and S. And that's why it is 4. Therefore, 4 isomers is the correct answer here. Let me put it this way. Let us draw the isomer this way. So, CH3, C double bond C, hydrogen on this side, and then hydrogen on the other side. Then we have a chiral carbon, and then OH, and then the hydrogen is behind, and then we have a methyl group. So, if we are assigning RS notation for this particular carbon, then we can put it this way. So, the OH is on the left hand side, so that is first priority. Hydrogen will get the least priority as per the Kahn-Ingold-Prelog rules. And then this methyl group will get the third priority. And then this is carbon connected to hydrogen but also connected to carbon and double bond. And therefore, that should get second priority. So, if we do a swap between 3 and 4, then 4 comes down, 3 goes here, 1, 2, 3. This is clockwise, this is R, and therefore the original is S, isn't it? And therefore 2S, and then this is higher priority, this is lower priority, this is lower priority, this is higher priority as per the Kahn-Ingold-Prelog rules. So our priorities are on the opposite side. This means it is E isomer. Therefore 2S, 3E, pent, because we have 5 carbon atoms in the parent chain, 3-ene-2-ol. That should be the correct IUPAC name. Now, we can also get 2R3E, pent-3-ene-2-ol, once we consider that the OH is behind us and the hydrogen is towards us, and then the methyl group here, and then whatever the rest here. On the contrary, once you put both the hydrogen atoms on the same side, then we can get 3Z, 2R, that is another isomer. We can also get 2S, 3Z, pent-3-ene-2-ol. That's why 4 isomers here.